falling in the water. That's one thing. Today what we're doing is trout season's coming up. So I'm just checking. It's been raining cats and dogs. So I'm checking out some local streams. And they're looking flooded. So I'm seeing which ones will be fishable when the season comes up. So, you know, it is what it is. Hoping the water level drops. Catch yourself some trout. But I think what we'll do for now is we'll just set up a little day camp. You know, and I think we'll cook some, hold on. Oh, there we go. I think we'll cook some chicken wings. And we'll use bacon as a garnish. Well, actually, I don't know which one is the main dish, the chicken wings or the bacon. But now what we're gonna have to do is, because it's been raining pretty hard for days, I mean, river's soaked to an absolute bone. I got all the protective cases on the equipment. What we're gonna have to do is we're gonna have to put the fire under a poncho because it's supposed to keep raining. Take advantage of this little break in the weather to get some wood. I'll show you a methodology I use for running a fire under a poncho in the rain in the very wet woods. And we'll also start it with a ferro rod as well. Here's a pretty good resource. It's dry right here, soak here. So we'll grab what's dry. Now I also brought fire starting materials such as cotton balls with Vaseline, in case this won't go with the ferro rod. It's great practicing skills, but you know, I really want to eat something too, right? And best to always play it smart and have extra stuff with you. I'll grab this up, we'll set up the poncho shelter, and we'll see what we can do about getting some wood. We're gonna have to split it up today. It's pretty wet out, so we'll do that as well.
Every tarp pitch I've ever done has always been an improvisation for the spot I'm in. We've got the sliding friction knots, S-beaners, another S-beaner. Pitch a little low. I'm expecting, I hear the thunder in the background. Multiple tie-offs. Generally, it's whatever the environment and conditions call for. Especially when you have a poncho that does not have a lot of room. The important things are, make sure that center hood isn't open. Make sure you have the main support is strong. It's right there. Big Easton aluminum peg driven in deep. Also looped around the tree. I don't know, it took me all of probably 5 minutes to set up. Partially because I have the frustic knots. So I can adjust this, slide it right along this ridge line to any position I want. This is like a fallen bit of oak here. Off the ground, so this upper part might be dry. I click up some tulip poplar, some other woods. Tulip poplar loses its bark quickly. You see the inside looks pretty dry. If I saw this up, split it up, despite the fact you see the outside is pretty darn wet, inside looks pretty good. Let's get all this in before the rain hits again. Saw up the wood a bit here. Pretty wet, but it is exactly what it is. least we gathered it off the ground. And what we're going to do is we're going to split this stuff up. It's a very fine little pieces. So what we'll do to get the fire going, oh, the nut right there, it's always a pain. Get the fire going, oh, let's see if I can just break it, there we go. Always a pain in that nut. What I'll do to get it going is we're going to try a ferro rod methodology. You know, if that doesn't work though, that's okay, because I also brought, we're going to make a baton. I also brought cotton balls of Vaseline. There's no such thing as cheating in firecraft. That's good wood. Make the baton about, I don't need a big baton, right here. So cut it right below this nut. Perfect. Oops. Everything's slippery, so you, I don't watch yourself. There we are. There's your nut. I want lots of little pieces. We can dump this wet bark, little slivers like that. Now that's small enough. I mean, that's tiny. Just what we need. This might be pushing it. We'll give it a try though. Huh. Yeah, that's what we want. More of those, the better. Definitely got dark quick though. Lightning. I think I'll call this batoning in a thunderstorm. not much you can do about it. Just one of those things, you know? Just one of those things. Gotta lie low. And keep batoning. On the positive side, we're lower. ridge lines are higher. So that reduces our chance of getting hit by lightning. That always makes you feel good. I mean, getting hit by lightning, not so much. So we're a little lower down, but we're higher above the river. That the nominal risks of a more light. There we are. Nominal risk of a flash flood up here. I wouldn't get too close to that river though. It's been raining bad for days, so. Another minute, we'll be done with the wood. I'm not big on the split wood fire, but some weather conditions really demand split wood. I'm usually a twig fire person, but for what we're doing here, this split wood fire is really going to make a difference. But for most of the times, why expend the energy, you know, if you don't need it? But we need it. Here's a split wood, and there are other resources being gathered right here. Water. Right from the tarp, right to my cup. I don't need to, unlike that river water, I don't have to treat this. We're gonna drink this straight up. So I'm still going. Ooh. Not too happy about this, but there's not like much I can do about it. Amazing difference a simple poncho can make though. Our water's doing great. Without this poncho, just another wet animal. Cowering from the storm. That's all we'd be. Now we're just a dry animal cowering from the storm. Is that all we got? We're doing good with water. That's how effective that is. Very effective. You have a full thing of water. The other cup is filling up too. That is overflowing. If I had another container, I'd put it out. Well, I think I might have another container, but I don't want to use it. I think that's all the water we need. Yeah, I definitely recommend carry a poncho with you, or small tarp, if you're going out. We're a good distance from getting out of here, so in weather that I don't want to walk around in on higher ground. You know, I don't want to go up that ridge line. I don't care about the rain, it's the thunder. So sometimes you have to hunker down. Give yourself a little tarp, or a better yet, a poncho, which is multi-purpose. This poncho is giving us water on top of providing us shelter. So it could definitely be a rain gear if we needed it, although we're totally gutted out in rain gear. Well, we're going nowhere. Absolutely nowhere. And our wood's dry. That's right, it's a wood stove. So how are we gonna get going? Well, in my pocket, look at all that birch bark we gathered up before. Put a good amount in here. Really flood that in there. Let's first see if we can catch it. If we can't, I'll ignite a piece on this and spread it over there. It's kind of tricky because everything's wet. No, okay, here's what we're gonna do. There we go. Don't go out on me. Don't you go out on me. Man, that was on the edge. I'll tell you, that was literally on the edge. That's got to be one of the trickier fire steel fires I started. We'll let this go. Hopefully it'll start. And we got piles of birch bark in there, so we'll see. Man, look at that birch bark go. Look at her, look at his rage. Let this go. It's that time again. Time for the sacred bacon. Stove is going great. Put the bacon right on the wings. Yeah, look at that. Stove is putting off some nice heat. We'll show you that in a minute. Even more bacon. This is gonna be great. This is gonna be great. I just know it. Grab our water. We have a full thing of water. See that? That's going right there. All this wood that was wet. Burning like a champ right now. We don't gotta worry about that causing a fire, I'll tell you that. Once you get a coal base, let's take a look at the whole shelter system. Now we gotta put the lid back on our, put a lid on our wings here. We're running it without any spark screens. There it goes. We don't need to obstruct the draft at all. simply because, well, it's so wet and there's no risk at all of sparks causing any trouble. There we are. There we go. The river's actually gone, it's actually gotten higher and muddier. See that? Oh yeah, it's gotten pretty wild down there. Look at that. That is like wild. Wild flooding. Man. The river definitely went up after that storm. Look at that. And our shelter's doing a great job. And that, my friends, is how you have fire under your poncho. Gotta keep up on it though, this wood is really wet. It's not like you can just, you know, absolutely leave it. But once you get that coal base, it'll all burn. All right, we'll let that go. Well, the metal's red. That's usually a good sign. And these, we'll let these, now that I've steamed them, we'll let this steam stuff boil off. So we'll get them nice crispy. They're actually fully cooked now, but we'll let this water boil off, crisp them up, and start to eat. Yeah, nice cherry red stove though. Feels warm actually. That's a power split wood fire. You're getting there. This is a marked improvement from before. So after cooking the wings, what do we learn? Well, we learned that that water got more flooded when the rain rolled in, and the lightning, so I don't know. I'm not sure if I'll be fishing that in a couple days or, you know, we'll see. So it's a nice expedition on that, so we get to see what the water is like. And also, value of a poncho, you know. Now I wasn't going to, go up those ridge lines and stuff. Not during that storm. No way. We'll crisp this up. So having a good knife too. It's always nice. Having a saw too. Those are always nice things to have. You can get a fire going pretty much almost any weather. You can get out of the rain. That helps a lot. I've seen people do it when the pouring rain. Actually, I've done it myself in the pouring rain. But man, in the rain directly off you, gives you opportunity to process your wood and do all the important stuff you gotta do to get the job done. Let's keep on cooking. This is looking good. It's looking really good.
Can you hear that sizzle? This is excellent. Some of the tarp water. Fresh off the tarp.
Mm. The wings and the sacred bacon. The wings are cooked, of course, in bacon grease. That's excellent. Try the wing. Great. When we finish this, we have a lull between storms, I think. And I need to get over that ridge and out of this valley before we get hit by another storm, because I don't want to be on that ridge during lightning. So we came to find out what's the story with the river, and it's even more flooded than when we got here. I don't know if the storm rolled through just this area, but I think we'll avoid this river for opening day. You know, we're just gonna avoid it. Yeah, or maybe by the time opening day comes, the water level will drop. But hey, we'll go to another river, you know? We need to pack this stuff up. Of course, I need to finish it. And get out of here, because it's getting dark again. I don't want to be caught out in another storm.
All right, please set up the campsite. It's all good. How's that water looking? We gotta go before the weather comes down on us again. And it's all uphill. Oh, look at that nasty little stick. All right, as always, thanks for watching. And if you like what you've seen, hit the subscribe button, give me a thumbs up, and y'all have a great day. Man, look at this. Always give you something extra to hang to the very bitter end. What hell of a storm blows through there. This ain't no brook. It's just pushing up the ridge. And now, thanks for watching. Not that I didn't mean it before. And look at this runoff. That's why that river is getting flooded. Whoa.